So, there's still plenty of nighttime left, so you vamps are in for a real treat. I am here with G. Tom Mack, whose song, Cry Little Sister, from The Lost Boys, quickly became the vampire anthem. Hi, G. Tom, how are you?
Hey, thanks, Electrish, for having me on. Pleasure. Yeah, Cry Little Sister, the vampire anthem, but it's been an anthem to so many other things over the years as well.
Now, the song, Cry Little Sister, really took the world by storm, and it still is. So after all these years, how do you see the evolution of how the song itself is seen and felt?
Well, Cry Little Sisters had quite a ride. I mean, obviously it's associated with Lost Boys, fantastic Lost Boys movie, but it's evolved in such an amazing way. I mean, there's people that never even seen the film that know the song. And it's applied itself to so many different ways, as I said, and people have gravitated to it. Can't really explain that, but quite pleased that it's been accepted the way it has been, and also been associated with this fantastic, iconic film.
Now, I know you're working on a musical about the Lost Boys characters. Can you please tell us about that?
Well, yes, I have been working for the last 5 years on A Lost Boys Story, which is the name of the musical from Lost Boys to film. And yes, God, I don't know where to begin here. I can't give away the whole story, obviously. But telling a bit of the backstory to where all the vampires came from and the basic storyline between all the characters, really. But I've written all the songs, and there's a soundtrack that's out now, and you can stream it on Spotify. It's called A Lost Boys Story, songs from the musical. But quite pleased with where it's at, but we're in a pandemic and we don't know what's gonna happen with Broadway and all of the things that we are aiming at with this musical. So, but I'm quite pleased as to where I've taken it, and so are my producers.
So you seem to have a very strong connection to this film and its story. So what is it about this film in particular that really resonates with you?
I do have a strong connection with Lost Boys, and a lot of what I wrote in Cry Little Sister was, I knew that I had to write a theme song that related to the film, but also there was a lot of me going on at that time in that film. So I related to the vampire, the sort of David's character, of being this sort of lonely inside, but very rebel without a cause kind of vibe going on with him. But yeah, Cry Little Sister was I really wanted to create something that really brought a family together. And not only the vampires, but all the surrounding characters as well. And yeah, it's amazing how that song has gone on to be a sort of anthem without people even seeing The Lost Boys. I can't believe there's people out there who've never seen the film, but yet they gravitated to that song. So, yeah, it's definitely, it does the heart good.
So, G. Tom, how was it working with the director of The Lost Boys, the late Joel Schumacher?
Yeah, working with Joel Schumacher, what a dream that was to be able to work with him. He knew my work before, and he reached out to me to see if I'd come up with a theme song for this movie, Lost Boys, that he was making. And so he sent me on a script, and I read the script and made a demo of the song. And he got back to me just saying, you have created the quintessential song for my movie, and you won't believe how well it's working. And I had no idea how well it was working because I had not seen the film at that point. But our relationship went far deeper after Lost Boys, just in that he was very supportive of me carrying on to do the musical once I started embarking on that 5 years ago. And it's just been a wonderful relationship. I miss my friend Joel very much, but I know he's here in spirit.
So, G. Tom, is there anything that you'd like to say to any musicians watching the show now?
Oh boy, how do you be encouraging and discouraging at the same time? Well, I'm going to be encouraging because there's so many discouraging factors that go on in just everything we do with music. But we are only doing it because we love it. So I think it's really important just to work on your craft, get that to be, whether you're a guitar player, songwriter, drummer, bass player, piano player, whatever, or just, you know, making music because you just want to do it. But as far as being successful with it, it just comes along by being good. And at some point you just have this innate feeling and you've got to get it out there. And I think musicians out there couldn't be in a better position with what you can, how you can expose your music these days with streaming and all the others. But, you know, it takes getting there. And I think it's all about authenticity and be authentic. I think that's the best way I can put it.
Thank you so much to G. Tom Mack for being on Static Realms Music Hour.
Oh, thank you so much, Electrish, for having me on. It's been a blast. There's a mask coming out soon saying, "Thou shalt not die," and you can go on gtommack.com and order your mask. Cheers.
West Coast, I got my Cadillac and catch a ride. Be that loner, be that guy. California, my kind of dreamer. Here I come in a vampire demeanor.